To certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay.
Oh, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so
joyous songs. Let us worship Christ, the newborn King. I do have a couple of announcements as we move into the evening and the holiday season. I want to remind you specifically about something happening at the end of the service. If you've not already done so, I invite you to gather candles for those in your household as we will be singing Silent Night and be doing it by candlelight. I do have a couple of other announcements for you as well. Quick reminder that the service for December the 27th will be virtual. We will have an opportunity for our Bishop Bill McAlilly to be offering our sermon for that day. He has prepared a sermon for our conference. So I invite you to please tune in for that. The scripture reading for the 27th will be John chapter 1. Verses 1 through 18. Also want to remind you Our offices will be closed on December the 31st and January the 1st. Your last day to get any end of the year giving in will be December the 30th. Our offices, again, will be closed on December the 31st and January the 1st. And now as we move to that time of worship and to this holiest of nights, I invite you to hear these words as we are called to worship. On this holiest of nights, we come, joining the shepherds who were stunned by wonder. On this most silent night, we come, our hopes and dreams, joining those of Mary and Joseph. On this night of carols and candlelight, we come, our glad songs joining with the choirs of angels over us. Let us pray. O God of love, you have brought us together tonight and blessed us with your very self. Open our eyes to the light of Christ, which glows in the darkness of a world engulfed in apathy, pain, and loss, a world separated from you. Speak to us now that we may hear the good news of your salvation. Bring us into the wonder of your presence. Fill us with that light and carry it out with us into our lives. Amen. This time we will light our Advent candle. I invite you to hear these words. We light the Christ candle to symbolize God's promise fulfilled.
For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace to all on whom his favor rests. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Many
I invite you to join me as we go to God in prayer. This is a prayer, or this prayer that I share with you comes from, or is attributed to, Robert Louis Stevenson. So again, let us go to God. Loving God, help us remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and worship of the wise men. Close the door of hate and open the door of love all over the world. Let kindness come with every gift and good desires with every greeting. Deliver us from the evil by the blessing which Christ brings, and teach us to be merry with clear hearts. May the Christmas morning make us happy to be thy children, and Christmas evening bring us to our beds with grateful thoughts, forgiving and forgiven, for Jesus' sake. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now we come to that time again in which we will reflect on and be invited to give of our tithes and our offering. I invite you to hear these words. Glorious God, we sing with the angels to celebrate the tremendous gift of your Son, Jesus. We rejoice with gladness. You give us wonderful joy and peace in our Savior. May we exult in your goodness with the exhilaration of children opening presents as we bring our offerings. We ask that our lives will reflect your joy and generosity. And as I said in our service on the 20th, you have a couple of options that you can give. You can mail in your tithe or offering to the church. You may bring it by the church, or you can give online by going to our website or clicking on the link at the bottom of our e-blast that we send out. We do appreciate your faithfulness in giving throughout this year, and we just encourage you to use your gifts, to use your talents, to use all that you are for the glory of God. So I invite you again to join me with this statement. We are an Advent people, a people of hope. For us, Advent is a time of waiting, and so we wait. We wait for the coming of the one who is the fulfillment of God's promise, the fulfillment of hope, the declaration that we have been redeemed. Even so, we are not a naive people. We know that the world in which we live will continue to be filled with pain and sorrow. We know that hatred and violence will continue to exist. We know that death and separation will continue to be a part of our lives. But because we are Advent people, we know that none of these things will win in the end. The Holy One is coming to make holy once again all that was, is, and ever will be. And in our waiting and our hoping, we work and worship, pray and play in all things, hoping that peace, love, and joy will reign in our lives and in our world, now and forever.
Oh,
It is Psalm 96, so I invite you to hear God's word. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works among all peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him, strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is king. The world is firmly established. It shall never be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity. Let the heavens be glad and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar and all that fills it. Let the field exult and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord, for he is coming, for he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with truth. Friends, this is the word of God for us, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
You may be seated. Well, here we are. Hopefully we have taken a moment to pause, if it's only for a moment. But nonetheless, I pray and hope that we have taken a moment to pause on this Holy of Nights. We are again in our separate places, and yet we are together. We really see what really seems to be kind of a tension in the world is the same tension that I believe we find in this of Nights. This story that we find not only representing the birth of Christ, but rather this whole story of the creation to the end that we read in the Bible, there's a bit of tension. There's this idea of already, but not yet. You see, we read the old stories, but hopefully they speak to us in new ways. We hear unwavering truths about God's love and action for humanity, and then hear that God is doing something new. Our scripture tonight, Psalm 96, tells us that the psalmist is singing a new song to the Lord. He is praising God for all that God has done. I'm reminded of Morgan Freeman's character in Kiss the Girls, Alex Cross. As he gets to the end of the movie, his niece has gone through so much throughout the movie, and he hands her a new set of strings for her violin. And he makes the statement, new strings for new music. Well, tonight is a moment for us to look with hope to the future, both the immediate and that which is to come. There's a hope on the horizon. After 9 months of a pandemic of death, of sickness, and of pain, there is a vaccine. Is it all we need? Will it move us further along, closer to the end of this pandemic? Only time will tell. What I have seen is hope. Hope in the eyes of medical professionals getting the vaccine and seeing a future that doesn't look as dark as it once did. And I will say this, and I didn't come to talk about the vaccine tonight, but in the darkness of our reality and the hope of a new future, we are set in the same frame of mind as those we have read about in the last few weeks. You see, the two birth stories in Matthew and Luke show us the tension facing the world. There is oppression, occupation, worldly kings fighting for power. There is violence, uncertainty, and more. It is in that moment, it is through those moments, that God chose to act. It is then and it is now that God has chosen to act. It isn't that he has been silent or inactive, but it is in the fullness of this moment God is doing something new. Psalm 96, from which I read tonight, is an enthronement psalm. It is a psalm proclaiming God's reign. Psalm 96 is one that David uses when he moves the ark to Jerusalem. It is in moving the ark that David is enthroning God in Jerusalem. The psalm has an interesting use within our lectionary as it shows up during this time of year and also at Pentecost. In fact, I read part of this psalm as a reading for one of our services during the Pentecost season. The psalm itself, while calling on a new song to be sung, is in fact the new song that should be sung. The psalm reactualizes this present moment for us, the reality of God's reign in these moments and the moments to come. I guess the question for us to ask is, do we recognize God's reign in the world? Do we recognize God's reign in our own lives? You see, tonight we come face to face with the reality that this baby in a manger changes everything and once again reminds us of who God was, is, and will be. It is through Jesus' birth that once again we see the manifestation of God's rule on earth. Much like Jesus' call for a decision, Psalm 96 calls for the same thing. Which king will you follow? For that decision sheds light on what is to come. Dietrich Bonhoeffer said this, "We have become so accustomed to the idea of divine love and of God's coming at Christmas that we no longer feel the shiver of fear that God's coming should arouse in us. We are indifferent to the message, taking only the pleasant and agreeable out of it and forgetting the serious aspect, that the God of the world draws near to the people of our little earth and lays claim to us. The coming of God is truly not only glad tidings, but first of all, frightening news for everyone who has a conscience. Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous work among the peoples. For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered among all gods." The opening words to Psalm 96 prompt us. They prompt us in whatever ways we can sing a new song. It seems like every year at Christmas time there is a new album that comes out full of songs mixed with oldies, and then there are some new takes on the holiday season. One such song is Hallelujah, written by John Legend and performed by Carrie Underwood and John Legend. The chorus goes like this, "Let the world stand still, the church bells ring, silent night as angels sing, Hallelujah, Hallelujah. Let the magic warm the moonlit air, hear the choirs join in singing everywhere, Hallelujah, Hallelujah." Well, Hallelujah means to praise joyously. Here's this new song that is shedding light on an old story. Now I'm going to end with a story. It's a story that we've already read this Advent season. It is a story that we have heard many times, but it is a manifestation of an old truth. God reigns. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in bands of cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. See, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." But when the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has shown us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in a manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them. Well, friends, tonight we gather. We gather celebrating this same thing that the shepherds celebrated and proclaimed. You and I have an opportunity at this point and at this time to learn a new song, to sing a new song, to rejoice in all that God has done for us, all that God is doing for us, and all that God will do for us. You see, as the psalmist says, we are to sing a new song. We are to proclaim something that is of worth. We are to proclaim something that is the truth within our lives. And that is that God reigns, that God is present, that God came down, and that God walks with us. So on this night of nights, on this holiest of nights, may we begin to learn a new song. May we begin to learn the newness of an old story and be transformed not only by the message of the story, but by the presence of the one in whom the story is about. May we find on this night many blessings. May we find love. May we find companionship. May we find grace. But most of all, may we sing a new song to the Lord of Lords. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. We've come to that time in our service. It's a time-honored tradition, really, in which we end with the singing of Silent Night, and we do it by candlelight. So I invite you, as you have prepared, to get your candles at home and light them as we ourselves light our candles and join us in the singing of Silent Night.
Sigh.
So long ago. Come to Jesus, or come to us, Lord Jesus. Be born in us this night, in our hearts, our minds, and our lives. May the light of your life be kindled in us and lead us to the shining truth of God with us, God for us and God in us. Amen. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.